that I was going to tell my husband, oh, I'm not going to think about that. I'm going to think, oh, he's just a good man. I'm not going to think about that I want to go outside his head. I'm not even going to think about that. I'm not even going to go that far. I know he's a good man. I know he, whatever he wanted, he would do it for me. He would go all out of his way. And I know that his love is real. See, these are the things I'm going to think of. You know, you have partners that sometimes things get on your nerve. You know how that is. I hope I ain't by myself, but you know I am. I'm okay. But things get on your nerve, but then I think about some of the things I do get on his nerve. But I'm going to think on the lovely things about him. Whatsoever things are a good report. The good report today was, when I went in the office, all 13 of us went in the office. I wasn't even thinking about it. I said, it don't matter if I get that job or not. I'm very content where I'm at as a supervisor. Mm-hmm. I don't want to be over 89 people. So I was good. I was going in the office, yes. You ready? You excited? Anyway, I think I got one man. He got it. And I was excited, oh, Mr. Daniel. That's, I'm so glad you got it. And then we had two more, not us. They were like, we're not worried about it because we have the education, the degrees behind it, and we know that we're going to get it. I said, you going to get it too? You want to get it too? And so I'm sitting down. And I'm like, man, so I like Mr. Dan. Mr. Dan's gonna be a good manager. Mm. And then when she said, well, we only can pick one, and I'm just smiling. Yeah, yeah, Mr. Dan. I said, not Mary, I don't like Mary too much. Mr. Dan is gonna be good. You know, I'm just saying, I'm happy. Because I like what I'm doing as a supervisor over my 15 people, not 89. Right. So we all sat down. And then they're like, you can't open it until you leave. And then they said, okay, everybody leave. Thank you for applying. Anthem, I work for Anthem, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Ohio. And Anthem, the people, the big people was there. They was all in the office as well. And I'm like, hey, how you doing? Glad to see you back. You know, everybody may leave. Sharon, we need to see you. I said, okay, well, I'm done. You know, it's so good. And they're like, congratulations, you are next SBU manager. Thank you. Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Almost, we get a hot 25 more people. That means 125 more people. I'm going to be over. That means the sixth supervisor, I'm going to be over. Okay. So when I was thinking about it, because I had been fasting, I said, I'm going to stand fast in the Lord. That's all I've been saying all day. Everybody's trying to get on my nerve, but I'm like, stand fast in the Lord.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know why they make this happen, but stand fast in the Lord. But I come to let you know that if we stand fast in the Lord and you do what you have to do, not worry about anyone else, but congratulate them. Look out for each other, the year of the saints. That's what we're called to do as saints. We're called to give God's word. We are called to minister to each other. We are called to pray and love on each other. And how do we do all these things? How do we stand fast? And how do we think on these lovely and good things and good report? How do we do it? We do it because the Holy Ghost lives inside of us.
Amen. Yes, yes.
It changes us. Yes. It makes us talk right, act right. Yes.
Lord,
and we need the Holy Ghost.
Yes, yes.
I'm so glad that the Holy Ghost lives inside of me. I'm so glad that it's moving inside of me.
Glory.
I'm so glad that I stayed. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that I stayed fast in the Lord. And I wouldn't let go. And I'm still not going to let go. Because I know if I didn't get this position, I was still happy. But thank God for giving me an opportunity. I don't give it to anyone else but God. you're going through, no matter what issue, I know it seems big right now. And I know it seems like that it's about to take you over. And I know it's a struggle. When I was a single mom with two boys. And I didn't play with them. It was hard to be the mother and the father. It was hard. But thank God that he sent me a husband.
Amen.
They help me out with those boys. And they're good young men.
Amen. Thank you.
Yes, they are.
Come on,
yes you do.
Come on. need you. And I will apologize real quick. When I go, tears will be coming down my eyes because I'm for real. If I offended you, you see, if I offended you, I offended you and I'm sorry. You know, but that's what this word is telling me. Keep on standing. Keep on. No matter. My husband gonna come to church, I'm coming. He gonna catch up after a while. But every other Sunday that he's not working, he's here. My children don't feel like going, are we going? I mean, I don't say anything else, like, we going.
That's right.
I don't do a lot of talking. We just going. Amen. And I'm telling you, the teenagers, I can send my kids to school. I'm just going to be honest. That's why I know the Holy Ghost is living inside me. And I send them. But I don't know what they're dealing with.
Amen.
Once they get there.
That's right.
And it was very difficult for me at the time to send Kenzie to Southeast. Yes. I had to pray on it, God, somebody better help me, guide me, because I really want to send him across town.
Mm-hmm.
But then at the same time, I need for you to know the people.
Because
you're hanging around too many.
Come on,
y'all. And to see my sons doing ministry, knowing that God kept us.
Yes, man.
And I can't be moved because they bust the door open. They come running.
Right.
So what would it look like for me as I'm sharing this with the single mothers? What would it look like that your children are so anxious to come and you are not? We got to think about that. We have to have the Holy Ghost for our kids, for us, but we got to see our kids, the future of our kids. And that all stays the same. They stand fast. I know it's hard. So at this time, I just want to pray for everyone.
Amen.
Anyone that don't have the Holy Ghost at this time, you want to come and receive the Holy Ghost, and you shall receive the Holy Ghost. Anybody at this time? If not, we want to pray together as a family.
Amen.
So I'm going to ask everyone to come forward. And let's